Hello, I'm Ryan Gerber, Hunter Product Specialist here at Hunter Engineering. Today we're going to cover some basic operational procedures with Hunter's new Ultimate ADAS. Hunter's Ultimate ADAS is based off of Hunter's WinAlign system. Many of you are going to be very familiar with the operation. We can still do wheel alignments, but now we've added the capability of adding ADAS target placement all around the vehicle. So let's start with how do we begin? So the first thing that we need to do is power on our sensors. What we'll do is we'll open the cabinet door on the sensor tower on this side. Simply press the button on the power supply for a moment. You'll see that it comes on and you can verify with the green light on the PC that it's on. In just a moment, the sensor tower will pair with the console and the display will come on. Once the sensor tower and console are powered up, the laser gimbals will go through a series of movements to initialize. Give it just a moment before continuing. At this point, you'll see some very familiar screens. Here we'll begin alignment just like we would with any of Hunter's WinAlign software. I'll begin the alignment, and if I were going to do just a standard wheel alignment with no ADAS procedures, I could continue by picking a vehicle. However, for today's procedure, we're going to do ADAS procedures. To initiate an ADAS procedure, we'll need a VIN. I'm going to use the barcode scanner to capture that VIN and move forward. Once the VIN is entered, you'll have a screen here to make sure that we want to do that ADAS procedure. So I will enable that ADAS procedure and I will continue without an alignment. We could continue with an alignment if that were part of our procedure. At this point, we need to mount our wheel targets. You will notice a new icon here on the bottom. Hunter's Ultimate ADAS program has opened. You will also see the WinAlign icon is present. Ultimate ADAS will automatically switch to the correct program for seamless operation. Should you need to manually toggle between the programs, it's as simple as clicking on the icon. To progress, we will need to add a qualifier here. We need to know if this is a four-wheel drive or a two-wheel drive. I'll choose the appropriate four-wheel drive model for this process. With this screen, we will choose what ADAS calibrations we need to do. We can either check those individually or drop down one row on the menu and select all. Returning to the top menu and confirming those calibrations. Now we're ready to compensate the vehicle. Once the vehicle is compensated, be sure to chalk the wheels so the vehicle doesn't move at any time during the procedures. Now that we've returned to the start calibration screen, let's talk about an important thing that we would want to do. Every morning, you will be prompted to do an ADAS gimbal calibration check. Let's go ahead and walk through that so you're familiar with it. Dropping down one row of keys, you'll see a calibration check. Simply click that. Our first step is determining home position. Take note of the camera beam and floor plane on-screen graphics. These will go through a progression from red to yellow to green as wheel targets are acquired and floor plane is calculated. You may see this progression at different times when moving the sensor tower or blocking camera sight. Should this happen, allow the system to reacquire target vision and recalculate the floor plane to green before continuing. Regarding home position, always follow the on-screen instructions and graphics to ensure that you're in the proper location. Ultimate ADAS will go to its calibration check height. It will instruct you to mount the targets that we've already mounted, and we will now do the calibration check. This is where the red lasers will come out and point at the front wheel targets on the top and the bottom and make a measurement. If the cameras and gimbals are in agreement, then you will get a pass on the screen and you can continue on. Let's talk about the accessories that will come with your Ultimate ADAS. Different manufacturers will require different accessories, but let's cover all of the bases. The first thing that everyone will have is this handheld remote. The handheld remote will control the console remotely so you don't have to walk up and engage with it. The next thing that all of you will have will be this barcode scanner. The barcode scanner will record different QR codes from some of these accessories for the printout and so that we know you use the correct target in the correct place. Everyone will also have a target rail and target carriages. On those carriages, we will have the target boards that mount to them. Then on the target boards, we will actually have those forward-facing camera targets or artwork. If you note, on the end of each one of these scrolls, you will see a number. That number will correspond to the on-screen graphics. Also, we have this flat plate radar, as well as surround view mats. Surround view mats may be rolled together because there may be more than one mat for a procedure. Again, you will see a number that will match an on-screen graphic, as well as QR codes that we will use for our barcode scanner for recording of the correct mat in the correct place. Last but not least, let's talk about the remote stand. The remote stand top will actually move so that you can aim that at the direction that the laser is pointing. The next thing you'll see here is the brake. So the brake will allow the remote stand to be placed level to the vehicle. Also, we need to adjust height. There's a trigger here. Pulling that trigger will allow for that height to be adjusted on the remote stand. You'll notice the remote stand has a receptacle on the front, and you may, depending on OE, have different accessories that will attach to this receptacle. Simply clip those in and continue on. Now let's look at the base of the remote stand. The first thing we want to point out is the bullseye. The bullseye is for the red dot laser. This allows for spot on placement. Next, we'll have a red line. The red line is to line up with the green line laser that will appear on the floor. Next, you will see these four pegs. You may have a procedure where the bottom of a target will need to be put between these pegs for stability. Now that we've covered the basic accessories, let's go ahead and move on to a procedure. What we're going to do today is the full ADAS calibration placement suite on this 2024 Kia Telluride. The first one that we're going to do is a sequential recognition here for the forward-facing camera. So this is a two-position calibration. Let's go ahead and begin. First thing we want to do is make sure that we have home position where we can see at least two targets. The next step we're going to do is make sure that we have room on the floor to position our ADAS tower. So what we'll do is we'll watch for two red lasers to come out and shine on the floor to ensure we have that space. After we have the floor height clear space, we'll have a floor height measurement. You will see the red dot lasers blink now. So once we have that floor height measured, we're going to need to mount the target board. Next, we need to mount the target, and we can see that that target ID is number 12. So, pulling targets from the drawer here, I can easily identify that this is target 12, and I'll go ahead and mount that on the board now. You'll notice on screen, the red X has gone to a green check mark, indicating that I have mounted the correct target on the board. Now I'll go ahead and place Ultimate ADAS Tower in front of the vehicle where we previously had made sure that we had space to do so. So the red dot lasers will shine on the base. There are two white reflective capsules. And what I'll do here is I'll bring one of those in, and once I get the red laser shining into the capsule, I'll release the brake, and then I'll twist the opposite side in. Once I've achieved that placement, I'll release the brake on that side. Now we'll continue on. Ultimate ADAS will automatically adjust for height. Now, I will go ahead and bring the target on center. As you can see, Ultimate ADAS is displaying a nice bar graph there for me to aim for the center. Once I've achieved that, some green check marks come out and I'm able to move on. The next step is where Ultimate ADAS will go ahead and adjust directly to the vehicle. Once that orientation to the vehicle is correct, I'll grab the scan tool, execute the calibration, and continue to the next. This completes the first part of the forward-facing camera. So, now that I've executed that calibration, I'll move the aligner back for the second step of this calibration. So, following those on-screen instructions, asked me to move the tower back. I've completed that. And again, similar to the first calibration, we're going to get those red dot lasers to come out and indicate on the floor where we're going to move the tower so that we can ensure we have the space to do this. So we can see those red dots have come out. I have plenty of clear space to complete this. We'll go ahead and measure the floor where we're placing. And next, we'll go ahead and place the tower where the red lasers are indicating. Same as before, I'll bring one of those lasers in and release the brake and then twist for the second. Again, Ultimate ADAS will make that height adjustment automatically. Now we'll move on to our lateral adjustment where I'll bring the target in line with the vehicle. Following instructions there on Ultimate ADAS screen, I have a bar graph to line the target up with. Again, Ultimate ADAS will position itself correctly to the vehicle, and I'll use the scan tool again for that second step in this calibration. After I've executed the calibration with the scan tool, I'll finish this procedure, and I'll go ahead and send all of these reports and measurements that I've just made on this 24 Kia Telluride 200net for safekeeping and future reference. This completes the forward-facing camera procedure. Up next with our 2024 Kia Telluride is going to be the forward-facing radar. We'll go ahead and use Ultimate ADAS to perform this calibration. Let's start. Once our tower is able to see two targets, we'll go ahead and automatically set the max height on the tower. And we'll display clear space so that we know we have enough room to complete the calibration. Next, we need to mount our radar cone. As you can see, we have a target ID of 329. So I will take the remote stand and target number 329 and mount that on our remote stand. Next, I'll record it with our barcode reader for further documentation. Next is floor height clear space. This will indicate where I'm going to place the remote stand. Once we've measured the floor, we'll go ahead and place the remote target. This is done easily by lining the red dot up with a crosshair on the base and the green line with a line on the base as well. Next, we need to level the remote stand. Again, we have a nice crosshair that we'll line up our red line laser with. And we'll make a fine adjustment to be sure we're square to the vehicle. After that adjustment's made, our final adjustment will be height adjustment for our radar cone. As you can see, I have a red collar on my stand. I'll simply pull the trigger on the remote stand and drop the radar cone down to the correct height in that collar. I will confirm it, and now I will move the tower out of the way to execute the calibration. We'll move to the step with the scan tool. We'll actually execute the calibration in the vehicle. Once we've done that, we can finish this procedure and again send all that documentation to the cloud HunterNet for future reference. For our third procedure here on our Kia Telluride with the Ultimate ADAS, we're going to do surround view mats. Let's go ahead and begin that procedure. So as typical, we see two targets. Our floor plane goes green, and the tower will set the cameras to maximum height. After that, we'll go ahead and display clear space so that we know that we'll have the room to roll our mats out. We have clear space defined. We can see that by the green lines and red dots on the floor. We'll move into a floor height measurement. Ultimate ADAS will take two different measurements to ensure that the floor is capable of accepting our surround view mats. At this point, we have our red dot laser and green line laser, and we can lay our mats out. We see that I need mat number 304, and that I'm going to line the red dot and green line laser up with that mat. I'll grab in the drawer and find mat number 304. Also, you'll notice I have grabbed my barcode scanner because I will have a QR code to record on this mat once it's positioned correctly. Once the mat is unrolled, what you'll want to do is just adjust your mat so that you have the vertical lines lined up with the green line. Once that's achieved, slowly draw the mat so that the red dot hits the circle on the mat. Once you have the mat properly positioned, simply scan the QR code for documentation of the mat. Once the driver's side is complete, we'll repeat the process on the passenger side. Now that we've placed both the driver's and passenger side surround view mats, we use our scan tool to go ahead and execute the calibration, and then finish it off by sending all of the documentation to the cloud and HunterNet 2. Thanks for watching.